good evening. This has been 1 year in the making, our second annual Holiday Pops concert. So welcome, everyone. I have a few people to thank before we get started. My board of directors, Ryan Heller, the board president, Shane Smith, our vice president, Susan Amuson, the treasurer. We have President Emerita Judy Edwina Smith. We also have Patricia Vigara, and then we have David Medley. So I wanted to thank everyone. Our POPS sponsors tonight, we have the Community Foundation of Merced County. We also have Gray Roberts and Betty Wolstenhume, as well as Jim Cunningham and Carlene Cunningham. And I just want to thank especially those three sponsors because they realize the value in this particular concert, in this particular community event. So I just wanted to thank them personally from the bottom of my heart. So without further ado, I'm going to welcome our guest conductor, Maestro Eric Choate, and I hope you guys enjoy the show.
Thank you. very good evening and welcome to all of you. Thank you so much for choosing to spend your evening with us today. My name is Eric Choate and I'm thrilled to be here conducting your orchestra this evening. It's such a pleasure to be here and to see all of you. For this next piece of music, we have two very special guests who I gather are quite well known amongst just about everybody in the audience. One is a multi-talented singer and children's choir director. This is Jenni Samuelson. And the other... She directs the Holiday Children's Choir, which will make a very special appearance later on this evening. And the other is Alex Simon, the director of these fine singers behind me, and a wonderful artist in and of himself. Please welcome Alex Simon.
Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at the 5 and 10 glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes aglow.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your
hopalong boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben.
Dolls that can talk and will go for a walk is the hope of Barney and Ben.
And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go.
There's a tree in the Grand Hotel,
one in the park as well.
The sturdy kind that doesn't mind the snow.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start.
And the thing that will make them ring is the carol that you'll sing right within your heart.
A pair of hopalong boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben.
Dolls that can talk and will go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen.
And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again. The sturdy kind that doesn't mind the snow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start. And the thing that will make them ring is the carol that you sing right within your heart.
Thank you.
Hello. I'm back. Hello. And I brought my daughter with me. This is Abby Samuelson. And we decided that we would love to put a little different twist on a holiday classic.
Did I come out too soon?
I need to go get my music.
How y'all doing? Having a good time?
Good.
My heart is very full, very happy. Hi, kids!
Thank you.
Holiday.
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 Please give it up again for the Merced Children's Holiday Choir. Yes! You have an incredible gift here in Merced, and that is these fine young musicians behind me. I had a great pleasure this afternoon of spending time with them and getting to make music with them, and this is something that's very, very special. It's truly a gift, it's a wonderful opportunity for these children, and it's a wonderful thing for the city of Merced. I just want to take a second to thank every parent in this room who has supported their children in musical education. And let me tell you that that is just about the most important thing that you could possibly do for a child, is to give them a musical education. So thank you. And of course, this is not possible without the vision and leadership of their amazing director, Jenni. We've got a couple more songs while they're up, and the next one is a lot of fun. Please enjoy Jingle Bell Rock.
Yeah.
thank you again. We're going to take just a second to get these young musicians off the stage and resume our program, so I thought I would give you a little bit of Christmas Carol trivia while we're waiting. It's a subject of great interest to me, you see. First of all, there's a very famous Christmas Carol written by Felix Mendelssohn, 19th century German composer. It goes like this. Do 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 do. Okay, you know it. So this piece was not written as a Christmas carol. Mendelssohn was commissioned to write a cantata, a large piece for orchestra, chorus, and soloists, for a major anniversary of the invention of the printing press. Very odd subject that he wrote this piece. And there's an aria in the middle of the piece that goes do 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 do, etc. And you know, after the piece was performed, somebody said, "Hey, Mendelssohn, you've written such a wonderful piece, but how often are we going to perform a cantata celebrating the invention of the printing press? Would it be okay with you if that tune were repurposed for, you know, something else? It's such a great melody." And Mendelssohn said, "Yes, I think that would be fine, so long as it never becomes a Christmas carol." Thank you.
Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Here we are as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Gather near to us once more. Through the years we all will be together, if the fates allow. Hang a shining star up on the highest bough. If the fates allow, hang a shining star up on the highest bough, and have yourself.
Merry Christmas.
I'm dreaming tonight of a place I love even more than I usually do. And although I know it's a long road back, I promise you. Christmas, you can plan on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents on the tree. Christmas Eve will find me
For our fabulous soloists, Alex and Jenni. Congratulations. We have two more numbers on the program, both of which involve every musician who's been a part of bringing this evening to you. So I think I've got one more piece of kind of depressing trivia, but I'll just share it with you while we get on stage. England, a country that historically was a monarchy. It had a brief period where the Puritans were in control. It was a commonwealth, and now it's a constitutional monarchy, you know. Okay. In around the mid-17th century, when the Puritans took control, overthrew the monarchy, the Puritans viewed the singing of Christmas carols to be totally inappropriate, unholy, disgraceful, heretical, et cetera, et cetera. So the singing of Christmas carols was actually against the law for about 14 years in England in the 17th century until I think it was Charles II, don't quote me on that, but I think so, when the monarchy was reinstituted, then people could joyfully resume the singing of Christmas carols. But what a dark period of time, I think so. Right. You're very kind to listen. Thank you very much. I think we'll get going with the next two pieces on our program. All right, one more thing. Please welcome the Merced Community College Choir. Thank you. You might not know this, but you're on duty to sing with us for the next song. If you look in your program book, you have all of the lyrics you could possibly need to sing every carol in this fantastic medley. So please do join us to the extent that you are in the holiday spirit and willing to sing with us tonight. I expect to hear some very robust singing from behind me and in front of me tonight. If we might be able to bring up the house. There we go. Hey, now you can read. No excuses.